Hi, I'm Anna Thomas. I'm the discipline head of screenwriting at the AFI Conservatory, and I'm the co-screenwriter and the producer of El Norte. In the scene with all the candles, we were sort of capturing the sadness of the moment when you know that you have to leave. And for Rosa, what that means is she has to leave a sense of herself, of who she is. When she changes her clothes, she takes off that traditional clothing that she wears all the time, that everybody in the village wears, and she puts on Ladino dress, which is Western dress, basically. She's becoming someone else. Nobody does something like that lightly. And she knows that she has to do it, but she doesn't want to do it.
Rosa?
She and Enrique at that point are in a life and death moment. He's going to get hunted down and killed. She probably is as well. Entire villages were erased in Guatemala at this time by the army. So that's what she says to her brother. She says, they kill us both the same here.
Y vos sos mujer, hombre.
Y vos sos hombre, pues. ¿Acaso no matan a los dos igual por aquí?
The candles are actually lighting the scene. We lit that scene and we lit many scenes with candles, not using any electric light, because we wanted to create that feeling of a very different kind of place than the place we live in, and immerse the audience in it. We wanted the audience to be completely immersed in the life and the look and the color and the feel and the rhythm of Rosa and Enrique's life, so that when they came into the United States with Rosa and Enrique, they would have that same shock of the new and the crazy and the different and what it felt like to them. But it was also done to see all those candles and create this kind of magical feeling of what they feel about their place, which is their home. And it has an almost sacred feeling to them. And now they're leaving it. Those kind of dream realist images come in to the story, come into the way we were telling the story at moments of intense emotion. People ask all the time, what is the meaning of the swarming of the white butterflies when she comes into the house and finds that her mother has been taken away? And I always tell people, the meaning of it is what you feel when you see it. And of course, it has references in pre-Columbian mythology, but you don't need to know that. All you need to know is how you feel when you see that. And it's the same with the candles. When Rosa is telling Enrique that she's going with him, that she's going north as well. So they go off on this incredible journey, crossing all of Mexico from Chiapas all the way up to the border, and find the coyote that their friend in their village named. And he tells them that the safest way to get across the border is not trying to go through the fence where they already were caught once, but to go through the old abandoned sewer tunnels that run underground there between Tijuana and San Diego. And this was something that we were told about by people who had done it. And it really was awful to hear about. But we felt we needed to recreate it because this is the exact and perfect image of kind of a belly of the whale scene. It's like, if you can survive this, you can get there. And that's where they encounter the rats. That was built months ahead of when we were going to shoot that, so that the rats could be happily trained in there for a long time and know where to go and what to do. Then, of course, the actors, we told them, you don't have to go in the tunnel with the rats. We can use stunt doubles, and we had stunt doubles ready for them there. But, you know, they took one look at what it would look like with the stunt doubles. And I remember Zydek, who had a rodent phobia. She did not like rats. And she said, you know, that this stunt double thing is like ruining my performance, you know? I have to go in there. Ultimately, they get through there. They make it. And they walk out to the edge of this little field and they look out across San Diego. And it's this amazing moment because it's the first time we see this blast of electric light. And it feels like the end of a movie. This is the moment where many immigrant stories end. I've arrived. I see the Statue of Liberty. In this case, I see the lights of San Diego. I made it. But in fact, it's the beginning. And then the title comes up for part three, which is the whole second half of the movie. And it's what their life is in the North. And then we find out really what the scope of that journey is. This movie has a life that goes on. I'm often asked, you know, what's the answer? What's the answer to this really effed up immigration situation that we have? I am a filmmaker and a writer, and what we can do is bring some humanity into a situation and allow people to see other people as human beings. I don't make policy, but if we do our part and if people communicate enough, and if the humanity of people can be communicated enough, then I think that's a start, because nothing good is going to happen if we don't see each other as human beings.